the 15 most beautiful tiaras in the world. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel and like it. Thank you. The Romanovs' wedding tiara. It is now kept in the Diamond Fund. This tiara was made for Empress Maria Feodorovna by order of Paul Wundt for their wedding. Subsequently, almost all brides of the Romanov house got married in this tiara. In the image of the wedding tiara, not only the Russian beauty was subsequently created, but also some other Romanov tiaras, including the famous Vladimir tiara. In all these tiaras, drop pendants were used, fixed in such a way that they swayed when walking. In the West, they still like to call it the Russian wedding tiara, and for good reason. Several generations of imperial brides married in it, starting from the second half of the 19th century. The girls wore this triangular tiara, along with the imperial wedding crown and other decorations given to them especially for the wedding. In its own way, it was a unique tradition. While European brides welcomed diversity, for example, wedding tiaras of the British royal family, Russians brought the continuity of their wedding images to the absolute. Tiara with palm leaf of Princess Alice. Alice was born on February 25, 1883, at Windsor Castle in the family of the youngest son of Queen Victoria, Prince Leopold, Duke of Albany. She married her second cousin, Alexander Teck, later Count Athlone, and almost all her long life she wore this amazing tiara, putting it on for special events. It is unclear who ordered or made it, but it consists of at least 7 yellow diamonds, most of which hang from the upper arc of the frame. The rest consists of diamonds arranged in the form of a palm leaf. What is really amazing is that Alice and her tiara saw the reign of 6 different sovereigns: Victoria, Edward VII, George V, Edward VIII, George VI and Elizabeth II, and attended 4 different coronations: Edward VII, George V, George VI and Elizabeth II. Princess Alice died in her sleep in 1981, just 52 days before her 98th birthday. And the diamond palmette tiara was given to her daughter, Lady May, who decided to auction the jewellery to Christie's in December 1984. The tiara was sold for $33,696 to an unknown buyer. Tiara Bathurst. It was presented to Countess Lilias Bathurst in honour of the birth of their first child in 1894 by her husband, the 7th Earl of Bathurst. This beautiful tiara in the style of the late Victorian era is made of old cut and rose cut diamonds in silver and gold and decorated with natural round and teardrop shaped pearls. After Lilias's death in 1965, the tiara was passed on to her grandson Henry, 8th Earl of Bathurst. Apparently, he gave it to his second wife, Gloria, because the tiara was sold at Christie's auction in July 2020 after her death. P.S. Gloria made headlines because she left nothing of her fortune, which she herself inherited from her husband, the 8th Earl of Bathurst, to her adopted children, children from her husband's first marriage. Her fortune of £33 million was left to 2 interior decorators. Tiara necklace, Maxwell antique cut and rose cut diamonds, removable frame, chain with links for wearing as a necklace, height 7.5 centimetres, necklace length 41.5 centimetres. The tiara was made around 1910. It was worn by Catherine Edith Collier, the second wife of the 3rd Baron Maxwell. The most famous event where she appeared in a tiara was the coronation of King George VI in 1937. On this occasion, she was photographed by the famous photographer Bassano. The Monkswell tiara necklace is a truly magnificent historical decoration that carries a rich history and cultural significance. Made in 1910, it became an iconic accessory for Catherine Edith Collier, the second wife of the 3rd Baron Monkswell. The sale of such a unique item at Christie's auction for £40,000 underscores its value to collectors and history buffs. This jewellery is an excellent example of jewellery art of the early 20th century, and its sale opens a new page in its history. Tiara of Christina, Viscountess Churchill, 1895 to 1972. In 1927, she married Major Victor Albert Francis, 1st Viscount Churchill, later 3rd Baron Churchill. His mother was mistress of Queen Victoria's bedroom from 1854 until her death in 1901, and he was an honorary page to Queen Victoria and a close friend of King Edward VII. For her new role at court, Christina purchased this tiara from the jeweller Hennell, made in 1930. It is made of old diamonds set in an openwork geometric frame. The design is typical for that time. The tiara could be turned into a necklace, two bracelets and a brooch. There is also an interchangeable set of emerald clip-on brooches that can be installed as the centrepiece of a tiara. Viscountess Churchill wore a tiara at the coronation of King George VI in 1937. This tiara was sold at Bonham's auction in September 2018 and reached £81,250. One of the last important events at the court of the Russian Emperor Alexander III was the wedding of his eldest daughter, Grand Duchess Xenia Alexandrovna and Grand Duke Alexander Mikhailovich, which took place on July 25, 1894 at the Peterhof Palace. It was a beautiful ceremony, conducted in compliance with all the traditions of the Romanovs. One of these traditions was the collection of a rich jewellery dowry for the bride. Wedding gifts made by her relatives became the basis of her jewellery collection. This large diamond tiara is number 32 in Ksenia Alexandrovna's jewellery album, and it is also indicated that it is a gift from Mum and Dad. Under the weight of the briolette-cut diamonds, the precious stems bend gracefully, forming the upper floral pattern of the tiara. In addition to the large round diamond in the centre, 14 pear-shaped diamonds are noteworthy, which in 1903 the Grand Duchess wore in the form of pendants falling on her forehead from a kokoshnik, part of the masquerade dress of the Russian boyars in the style of the 17th century. During the Russian Revolution, Grand Duchess Xenia Alexandrovna decided to give all the jewellery to her son-in-law, Prince Felix Yusupov, so that he could hide them until better times in his Moscow mansion. However, in 1925, the treasures were found. This floral tiara could be seen along with other jewels on the inventory table before they were disassembled and sold for the industrialization of the Soviet Union. After the Russian Revolution, Alexandra Fyodorovna's rich jewelry collection became a kind of financial security cushion for the imperial family. The Empress came up with a secret code name for the jewelry. When, in letters from 1917 and 1918, she asked for better packing of the pharmacy or taking care of medicines, she was referring to her jewelry, Alexandra Shura. Tegeleva's nanny remembered this. Before the Romanovs moved to the Ipatiev house, Shura helped sew precious stones into bras, hats and buttons of the Grand Duchesses. According to the inventory of experts, one of whom was illiterate and signed the document with three crosses, a total of five tiaras were found. Another tiara, pictured, can be mentioned in the list as a diamond headband for 600 rubles. This product was not only broken, but also devoid of diamond briolettes. The tiara was not created to order for the Empress, but obviously, this work was done in the second half of the 18th century by Oscar Massin. The fate of this product is not exactly known, but in an important private collection, there is a similar tiara with briolettes from the same workshop. The emerald and diamond tiara necklace, presented by Queen Victoria to Duchess Alexandrina of Baden, is another excellent example of royal jewellery with a rich history. This gift, made in honour of the wedding with Ernst II, Duke of Coburg, reflects the traditions and cultural ties of that time. The tiara, which was also worn by Princess Victoria Adelaide, Duchess of Saxe-Coburg-Gotha, continues to tell the story of the royal family and their tastes in jewellery. The sale of this unique piece at Christie's auction for $141,500 in 2002 highlights its importance and appeal to collectors around the world. Such jewellery is not only the epitome of luxury and elegance, but also serves as evidence of historical connections and personal stories that they carry through the centuries. Tiara for the Dollar Princess. Lady Paget, 758 diamonds, with a total weight of 47 carats, 13 emeralds, weighing 40 carats, Boucheron, 1902. Costume. The train of Mrs. Arthur Paget's Cleopatra costume was made of black crepe de chine, embroidered with gold scarabs. The bodice, sparkling with gold and diamonds, was supported on the shoulders by straps of large emeralds and diamonds. The square headdress was made of Egyptian gold cloth. The sides, similar to sphinxes, were encrusted with diamonds, and in the middle of the forehead was a large pearl. In the upper part of the headdress there is an ibis with outstretched wings made of diamonds and sapphires, followed by peacock feathers, pearls and amber. The rest of the headdress consisted of uncut rubies and emeralds, all of real stones topped with the precious crown of Egypt. There were necklaces of various precious stones around her neck, and a jeweled belt ran down to the hem. The tiara with clovers, created for Isabella of Bavaria, is another example of exquisite jewellery that passes from generation to generation and carries historical value. This ornament, symbolising good luck and well-being, was passed on from Isabella of Bavaria to her daughter, and then to her daughter-in-law, which emphasises its importance in family history. The sale of the tiara for $27,500 in 2018 indicates the continued interest in such items among collectors and history buffs. The use of approximately 580 and 750 gold, 800 silver, as well as old cut and diamond cut diamonds decorated with the Austrian stamp of 1872 to 1922 makes this tiara an outstanding piece of jewellery. The tiara's height of about 60 mm and weight of 87.6 g indicate its impressive size and quality, which makes it not only a beautiful accessory, but also a valuable collection item. The Torsade de Chaumet tiara, created in honour of the 200th anniversary of the Maison's High Jewellery Workshop, is a real work of art. This tiara reflects Chaumet's craftsmanship and innovative approach to creating unique jewellery. An interesting feature of this tiara is the movable diamond twigs that sway when moving, adding playfulness and elegance to the product. This not only demonstrates a high level of jewellery craftsmanship, but also creates a dynamic effect that attracts attention and admiration. Such tiaras are not just decorations, they are symbols of luxury, tradition, and the continuous pursuit of excellence, which are passed down from generation to generation. This unique piece of jewellery reflects Chaumet's craftsmanship and innovative approach to jewellery creation. Tiara Kokoschnik Rosenberg. The Kokoschnik with diamonds and garnets was made by the Danish court jeweller Dragster in the 1930s by order of Prince Viggo, Count Rosenborg, 1893 to 1970, grandson of King Christian VII of Denmark. He ordered it for his wife, Princess Viggo, 1895 to 1966, born Eleanor Green, American. The prince and princess did not have children of their own, so Viggo's daughter-in-law, Princess Margareta, 1899 to 1977, inherited the tiara. Margareta was born into the Swedish royal family and married Prince Axel of Denmark. Then, the tiara was worn by Countess Ruth Rosenberg, 1924 to 2010, wife of Fleming, son of Margarita and Axel. But after her death, the jewellery was put up for sale at an auction in 2012. The estimated cost is more than $200,000, but the tiara was never sold. It was re-auctioned at Sotheby's in May 2014, where it was sold. The buyer's name was not disclosed. The wedding of Princess Yolanda of Savoy and Count Giorgio Carlo Calvi in 1922 at the Quirinal Palace was a landmark event, and the tiara presented to her by her parents, King Vittorio Emanuele III and Queen Elena, is an important part of this story. Fratelli Petacci Jewellery Workshop, which made the tiara, is known for its craftsmanship and quality of work. An interesting fact about the tiara is that some of its diamonds were removable, which allowed them to be worn separately in the form of rings or earrings, which added versatility and functionality to the decoration. After the death of Princess Yolanda in 1986, the tiara was sold at Christie's Jewels Auction. This indicates that items with a rich history and royal origin continue to attract the attention of collectors and connoisseurs of jewellery around the world. The tiara created by Joseph Chaume for Hedwig of Bourbon-Parma is an excellent example of jewellery art of the early 20th century. Made of platinum and diamonds in 1919, it reflects the elegance and luxury of that time. Preserved in the family until the 1950s, the tiara was subsequently sold, but its history continued when the jewellery house of Chaume bought it at auction around 2000. Since then, it has become part of their collection and adorns various exhibitions, demonstrating its beauty and historical value. The tiara attracted attention not only because of its beauty, but also because it was worn by famous personalities such as Stella Tennant, Sophie Marceau, Valerie Lemercier, and marine-vacked. It became especially noticeable after Anne Hathaway wore it for the promotional filming of the film The Princess Diaries, as well as when a copy of it was used in the film. This highlights not only the historical significance of the tiara, but also its influence on pop culture and fashion. The Leuchtenberg Emerald Tiara is a truly magnificent piece of jewellery created by Jean-Baptiste Fossin in the period from 1830 to 1840. This tiara is known for its exquisite emeralds and elegant design, and it is a significant part of the history of the Chaum Jewellery House. The special feature of the tiara is that its central element can be transformed into a brooch, which makes it not only beautiful, but also a functional decoration. This allows the owner of the tiara to use it in various images and at various events. The tiara is part of the Chaumet collection and is presented at the exhibition Josephine and Napoleon, which is dedicated to the history and influence of these historical figures on fashion and jewellery. The exhibition highlights the connection between history, art and culture, demonstrating the importance of preserving historical luxury items. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel and like it. Thank you.